Did you know that this steering stick can launch you in the air so that you can get arrow time? This is extremely useful when a lino approaches you and you can shoot the lino right in the face to knock it down. Not only can you use the steering stick on linos, but Gleeoks too. Speaking of Gleeoks, when Gleeoks start to get up, you can also use rocket shields to get up in the air and shoot them. Also, while we're up in the air, check this out. Key size can make your arrows go extremely far. It didn't take out the Gleeok, but it definitely has a very far reach. Now here's something fun I wanted to do. So Bokoblins actually pick up your weapons if you take their weapons. So I have a bomb sword. I'm just gonna drop this on the ground. And then I'm gonna just throw some shock fruit in order to have the enemies drop their weapons. There we go. Grab their weapons. Now they can't pick that up. And they're gonna be forced to pick up the bomb sword. That's right, buddy. You're gonna regret picking that up. All right, the boss Bokoblin gave the signal and they're all gonna do their thing. And yep, he just blew away. Speaking of using weapons to raid enemies, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. And we've got their champion, Professor Death Knight, to answer some questions. Hey Professor, isn't Raid Shadow Legends a mobile game with over 650 unique champions, billions of customizations, tons of fun bosses, and even more incredible stuff coming out every month?
Hell yes.
And aren't there endless ways to play with both PvP and PvE modes, casual and competitive experiences, and tons of different strategies?
You really do your research, huh?
Yes, definitely.
And the best part is all the content is completely free. And in celebration of Raid Call of the Arbiter, if you get the game now, you'll be able to get the Mighty Orc Warlord Artak if you log in for 7 days between now and July 24th. And if you're new to the game, if you use my link below or scan the QR code right here, then you'll get a free starter pack with tons of cool loot. So go down to the description and download Raid Shadow Legends and join the growing player base of over 80 million players today. And thank you to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this video.
Remember, all assignments are due on Wednesday.
Now, something else that you can do is when the Bokoblins start to charge up and get ready for their attacks, you can drop down bombs ahead of time, just like this. And boom! You could also do this with the other time bombs. So I'm just going to go ahead to the Zone Eye devices and select some of these time bombs, drop them, and back away. That's a lot of fun. Now, this is a classic. Grabbing a bomb barrel is a great way to break enemy formation because when you protect yourself with a shield, oh man, you are very safe. And actually, some bomb barrels do more damage than other bomb barrels. And boom. Well, okay, that was a weaker bomb barrel, but there are stronger bomb barrels in the world. Something really cool that you can use against linos are puff shrooms. Now, linos are supposed to be one of the smartest enemies in the game, but they go really, really dumb when you start to throw puff shrooms. They have no idea. You can see that question mark showing up. If you have powerful weapons, you can mount the lino with no problem because you can see that popping up. Get on top of it, beat it up completely, and you can hop off of it again and throw more puff shrooms. Not only can you use puff shrooms on linos, but on enemies, you can use puff shrooms as well in their camps, and you're safe. The moment you throw puff shrooms down, enemies have no idea, and you can try to pull off some sneak strikes with the puff shroom, so feel free to do that. Speaking of puff shrooms and sneak strikes, when it is raining, enemies have a harder time hearing you, and especially at nighttime when some enemies are sleeping, you can just slowly approach them and go for a nice sneak strike doing over 8 times damage. And if you have the 8-fold blade, it'll be doing times 16 damage on a sneak strike. So very cool thing to use. Now, if an enemy spots you, like we said, all you gotta do is throw your puff shroom on it, go to the back. They are very dumb once puff shrooms go out, and pull a sneak strike there too. Now, this is a really interesting one. If you're trying to do a challenge or trying to get to a chest and you don't care about drops for an enemy, you just want to nuke them, you can use the ancient blade. Literally, I'm doing the lino run and I'm just taking them out. It's a world record time to completely clear enemies. So here is the white lino and it's dead. So this is not a surprise to a lot of players, but it's just good to have this as a backup in case there's an enemy you don't want to deal with. I'm just chucking it at it. And yep, you can throw ancient blades too. If you're in this area in the Colosseum and have ancient blades, you would get Majora's Mask right here. By the way, don't think that you can throw the ancient blade at everything. Here is me attempting to use it on a Thunder Glioc, and yeah, it just does regular damage. Now, this is a fun one. These are the Frocks that live in the depths. Now, Frocks are really fun because we're going to be using a strategy that requires us to do the same thing over and over again. It's called the Bomb Strategy. Now, I got its attention over here, as you can see in the shot. Just shot a little cannon at it, and here we go. It's going to open its mouth and go for the Zuck, and as it starts to do that, I shot my cannon. It's chewing it up, and cannons just act like bombs, and yeah, there's the explosion, so don't try to climb it while it does explode. So then after you knock it out, it's going to throw you up in the air just like this. Here we go. It's standing up, and it's going to try to eat you, so just go ahead as soon as you open the air, and just, again, more bombs in its mouth, just like this. And you should be able to rinse and repeat this part over and over again until it's pretty much dead. This is a very interesting thing in the game. You can actually make yourself dual hybrid arrows. So I'm just going to throw a fireplace down over here and light it up. Okay, all right, let's just hit the flint. There we go. And take out a shock fruit, for example, and you're going to light up the shock fruit on the fire. So run over the fire and then aim at the enemy. And check this out. Look at the fire and electric at the same time. So if you want to experiment and figure out some things that you can do, if you leave it too long, the fruit will burn. So once you get the electric fire together, you're going to have to use it immediately. How practical this is, I don't know. But if people want to experiment and figure out other arrow combinations, let me know. Speaking of some combinations, what if you try to go with an ice slash electric combo? So I'm just throwing a dragon horn here, completely freezing up some enemies, seeing if there's any left on the ground. I killed off a bit. Here's a silver one, and then I'm going to go ahead and throw a shock fruit. Let me just get away a little bit, and then we can see what the shock fruit does. And you can see, yeah, that's a big AoE around it. So when you shoot shock or an electric item at a frozen enemy, it's going to amplify the area. Now, the reason I'm not getting frozen at all right here is because I'm wearing a completely resistant ice helmet. Now, in our last video, there was an amazing comment that suggested that we use Sidon with Moldugas in order to get an amazing attack with arrows and bombs. So I'm like, yo, we need to try this out. So I see it approaching me. It has a question mark. I'm going to tap Sidon, so that way I have the water bubble, and it's gonna knock me in the air. Now check this out. I back up, and then I'm just gonna switch to bomb mode. So you have a free arrow time in the air, thanks to the Molduga, literally. And I'm just gonna use my 5-shot Lino Bow or 3-shot. I don't even know which one I'm using. I'm just shooting bombs at it completely. And then when you drop down, look at that, dead. And you can hear its little cry. That is one of the coolest things I've seen, and I'm mind blown by this. Okay, here's something really fun. If you pick up a rock and do ascension, you can go through that rock. Now, what's the purpose of going through that rock? Well, you get yourself arrow time or bullet time, and you can take out enemies. Do they see me? Oh, they see me. I'm going right through. I'm gonna jump out, and there we go. Boom. And these guys are dead. Now, a lot of people may know about this one, but I find it very important that when you use Muddle Buds, that you prioritize the strongest enemies in the camp. For example, in this one, we have a silver boss Bokoblin, and I want this one to be the one really affected by it because the silver boss Bokoblin is the strongest enemy here. And because of that, that silver boss Bokoblin is going to go after the armored enemies, and yep, there's the armor broken completely and just start wrecking every single thing in the camp. And all the other smaller enemies are going to be attacking the silver boss Bokoblin. Oh, yep. Someone got a crit shot on him. Speaking of Muddle Buds, when you're fighting a Lino and you shoot it at it, it actually delays them for a little bit of time and it slows down their animation. So you can hop on them, beat them up, and you hop off. And then you can shoot another Muddle Bud at it and it kind of semi-stuns them for a split second. So if you're in a good position, you should be able to keep delaying this Lino over and over again. There you go. See that stun? Now, this is something that a lot of people like to combo with in the game, and putting bombs on shields are very important. One, for giving you the height. Two, for giving you arrow time. And a lot of people do a lot of crazy things where they add glide suits and they can do literally anime-style attacks with these bombs. So let me know what crazy things you guys do when you put bombs on your shield and then just blow up in the air. And what crazy combos can you do? I'm just so curious because I know we're going to be making a much more advanced guide later on as I get better at the game too. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button. You won't regret it. Just go ahead and do it so we can get more videos like this. These are really fun to make. I am extremely mad that I found out about this when I was like over 500 to 600 hours in the game. Now, there's a bunch of boned enemies below me, right? And these boned enemies come to life when you get close to them. But did you know that if you shoot a dazzle fruit at these enemies, they literally instantly nuke and just die? You don't even have to make contact with them. How insane is that? I'm just gonna throw this one at it. And it's dead. That's it. It's crazy. Now, this doesn't really work on Stalnoxes like the other enemies, so keep in mind it's going to be for all the weaker bone enemies, and Stalnoxes pretty much just go for the explosive arrows and shoot at its head. It's really easy stuff to take these things down. Now, there were a lot of questions about gloom weapons. Now, when you hit an enemy, you can see that gloom does take place. I'm holding a giant two-handed gloom weapon right now, and you saw the heart disappear, but because we're on the above ground, it all worked out pretty well. So a big question is, what can you do with gloom weapons that doesn't drive you insane? I actually have a gloom spear over here attached to a rocket. Let me just break that off for you. And I'm gonna fuse a gloom spear to a gloom club, and it's gonna do 90 damage, and it has durability up. We can go ahead and see, are we gonna get double gloom effect, or is it just the same exact one? And it doesn't look like I'm losing crazy amounts of health, so it seems that it does the exact same thing as having one gloom weapon. Now, something else a lot of people wanted to experiment with is what happens when you put a light dragon part on a gloom weapon, because the light dragon part is going to heal you while the gloom weapon is going to take you out. Now, here's the what you got to know. The gloom weapon is going to take out pretty much one heart every so often, while every single hit with the light dragon horn is going to heal one HP or 1/4 of your heart. And we can see this over here when we approach these enemies. So here we go. Kind of healed up myself there. One gloom heart attacking the enemy again. Lost a heart. Then I'm going to approach it again. Gained a little bit of a heart as well. So it's a kind of a counterbalance, but I don't know. I don't really think it's too efficient or inefficient. It's weird. Now, something I suggest if you want to just deal with the gloom weapons and not lose any health is attach the gloom spear or whatever gloom weapon to a normal weapon. That way it's the extra piece on it. That's pretty much what you do, but you'll notice it breaks pretty quick. So that's a way to use gloom weapons without taking any damage. Attach them to a regular weapon as the base. Now, while we're on the topic of gloom stuff, let's take a look at gloom hands. And what I have in my hand is a contraption known as the quad cannon. Now, you don't need to be this extra. You can just use two, but sometimes this is a very efficient way of taking out gloom hands. And so what I do is I angle it at a certain angle, just like this, and I start to just shoot the gloom hands, because when they hit them, it's going to just explode, kind of stun them, and you can take them out pretty quick. You can't even see gloom hands in this segment. It's already dead. Oh, by the way, I didn't mention this before with the gloom weapons, but when you attack a lino on the back with a gloom weapon, even when you're at full hearts, look at that, you do not lose any hearts. This is just good to know. It's a fun fact. And if you're, you know, it's a combat video, so you got to know things about weapons and fighting in the game. This is a really simple one. It's literally going to be throwing different elements at chews so you can get yourself more elements of a certain choice. So here's some blue chews coming at me, and I'm like, okay, let me throw a fire fruit at it. And here we go. Didn't hit all of them, but look, I got some fire chews. And here's an ice fruit. I'm gonna throw it at this chew and got an ice chew. There we go. Got my jelly. So there you go. That's how you get different element stuff. Woo! Now you guys know how to do that. Now, these are one of the enemies I had the hardest time in the game with. I, for some reason, constructs just drove me insane. Oh, thank you, Silver Bokoblin, for helping us. But there's an indicator of when you're supposed to dodge or parry these enemies. And that's going to be when their eye glows. As we zoom in here, you'll see the eye. There it is. And boom, you can parry right when they do that, or you can get ready for a flirt. This Silver Bokoblin needs to go. We are trying to do an example here. Please go away. Here we go again, and boom, eye glows, and we just parry it away. Okay, you gotta go. And when it's getting ready to attack, let's go for a flurry rush this time. So we're gonna back up as soon as the eye glows red, and we move in for that flurry rush kill. So it all comes down to the eyes with the constructs. Speaking of soldier constructs and captain constructs, hey, what about flux constructs? These things are actually really fun to just bully. I don't know why. You could just remove parts of it and it literally cannot do anything to you. So if you take out the arms, just like that, grab the other arm, and it's going to attack you and it literally cannot do anything to you. This works on flux construct ones, this works on flux construct twos, and it works on flux construct threes. Okay, so there's things that you can do with your Ultra Hand, with your recall ability, and with your fusion, technically, because all these weapons I'm putting together are fused, but now I'm ultra handing them. And basically what I do is when I approach a group of enemies, I'm going to just simply just move it around just like this with my ultra hand, and then I'm going to hit my recall. So it does a little death spin. Now you can make way better weapons than me. These are just some average weapons, nothing crazy, but it knocks out enemies. It literally pushes them. There you go. There's a Bokoblin dead. Here's a group of Bokoblins, and I'm going to throw a Frost Gliok horn at them. Oh, I froze too, but it doesn't seem to do much damage to me. Let me just go ahead and throw another one here. And something cool that you should know is that when you hit an enemy that is frozen, it's going to do times 3 damage. Now, also something to note is that you can blow these enemies away into the water with your fan. And I know if you're using Tulin, I don't know why I'm saying that name wrong. You could also do that. We did that in our Sage video. But yeah, with a fan and not having a Sage, these are the results that you can do. You can even blow away the silver boss Bokoblin into the water. Now, something pretty broken. If you happen to freeze the water and you have these little square ice blocks showing up, you can actually fuse those to your weapon. I do this here with a broadsword, and this is actually a really OP thing. It's a little bit chaotic here, but you can swing it and create ice platforms as well as creating wind. This silver boss Bokoblin is going to be moving closer towards me. I'm going to get on a platform, and as I head up here, I'm just going to whack it, and it gets blown away into the deep parts of the water. In the heat, it does melt, so keep that in mind. But just look how far it blows enemies. So cool. Now, when it does rain, enemies do get a little wet. And what happens when you shoot something electric at enemies that are wet? Yep, amplified electric damage. So whenever an enemy is wet or it's raining, you want to go in with electric items or attachments or just electric attacks. Hey, we're back to more Lynel stuff. Now, check this out. If you go ahead and you drop a Zonite device down in front of a Lynel, it's actually going to take an advertisement break and stop attacking you. Check this out, ready? It's gonna come over to me, and then it's going to roar, which gives you an open opportunity to shoot it in the face. Okay, one more time. It's coming for the charge. It sees it, it yells, you shoot it. Speaking of Zonite devices, check this one out. So if you go ahead and shoot a Hoverstone in the air, you can go ahead and just ascend right up to it. So you can have an advantage over many enemies. This is not going to just apply for a Lynel. This is going to apply for a lot of other monsters. Feel free to let me know and timestamp the video when you're in the comments exactly what monsters you would use this on. But for the Lynel example, I feel bad. We're torturing this Lynel this entire video. We're going to just shoot it in the face. Get on top of it, ride it, and then as soon as we get knocked off, I just go ahead. I'm gonna go and ascend right back up on this Hoverstone, and I'm just gonna wait for a good spot, and then bullet time it again, and we just rinse and repeat. This one's pretty fun. If you have any ruby weapons or fire weapons and you approach a ice enemy, that's gonna be pretty simple. I love putting rubies onto shields because one, it's keeping my character warm, and two, if an enemy goes ahead and attacks me, that's what happens in the ice areas. It just instantly dies. So that's something I like to do. Now there is another ice enemy over here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and take my boomerang, going to attach a fire breath Lizalfo's horn to it. So another fire item, fuse that and throw it at it. There we go. And it just eviscerated midair. And I might as well show you the polar opposite. That is me with a sapphire shield. And you just saw that red choo-choo get destroyed and turned into a white choo-choo. And here is a fire Lizalfos that sees me. I got my shield ready to go. All it has to do is just hit me and the counterattack. It's done. So another fire enemy destroyed. Now, while we're on taking out enemies with different elementals, we're in the fire area, and water does pretty well here too. So I fuse an opal onto a sword, and opals act like little magical weapons too, and I got water balls coming out everywhere. And I just hit this talus, and the talus already just lost its main heat, and then I could go ahead and start to break or attack its little stone there. So just whack that. If it gets too hot, no worries, and then just hit the top. And it's going to drop again. It's going to get weak. If it drops, no worries. I just have to back up. You can aim by throwing the weapon, so you can hit the exact spot. And just like that, the talus is going to go down. But this is a combat video, and that's pretty boring, so I came up with another fun ways for you to take down these taluses. Now, the first one was adding a fire hydrant to this robot over here, and I activated the bot, and it just completely ran up on the talus. So this is just fun to watch here. That's it. It's going to drop the talus. It took it out. Yep. pretty fun. And then you can go to ahead and just whack it completely. Now, something else I did was also add a fire hydrant to the hover stone that we talked about before. And once you activate it, you have the water coming out, and wherever you leave the stone, that's where it's gonna stay while it drains your battery. But if you notice, it's not really eating my battery too much. So what I'm gonna do over here is just place it above this talus. That way the water could just fall on top of it. And yep, there you go. The talus is like, oh man, I got water on me, can't fight anymore. And it's dead. Yep, those are some ways you can take down Igneo Talus. Now this is a battle talus, and they're really not that hard to deal with. All you have to do is simply just get underneath it, have your ascend ready, and then go right through the top. Now, battle taluses are cool because you can collect some of the arrows from the bokoblins if you just dodge. It's obviously limited, but it's pretty cool. And then you just have to get on top and hit that rock, and that was a launch. And these bokoblins are like, what? They're just done. Now, something else you can do with taluses, they throw their stones at you. You can just whoop, go ahead and rewind, and it'll go right back and hit the talus and also stun them on the floor. And you can go ahead and just beat them up as well with that. Also, real quick, there is a blood moon happening just as I killed it. And this is the first time I've ever been able to document me killing something as a blood moon happens. Is it going to show back up on the floor after the blood moon? I don't know. Let's find out. And it did not show back up, and this one's dying. Okay, so the blood moon did not revive it. Okay, I just wanted to test that out, and now you know the results from my video. Now, something really cool that you can do is add a glider to your shield, because this can also give you some airtime. So if you back up, get yourself ready, and you're gonna do a shield surf and then press your arrow button and boom, just like that, you were in arrow time. Very nice, very nice. Now, if you feel like becoming a mage in the game, well, you just have to take out these trees over here that come to attack you. This one's by Satori Mountain. They always seem to be dropping sturdy, thick stick, and they have a very high durability. That's kind of their passive. So what you want to do is go ahead and add some gems to these. So I went and added a ruby to one, and I got my fireballs just like this, and here we go, whoop, fireballs. And then I added the topaz to the other one to get ourselves some electric balls. You get some cool elementals coming out. You can do the same thing with ice. I actually think ice is the most broken one. I just wanted to show some fire and electric. I feel like I do a lot more ice stuff in this video. Something cool you can do is also, if you want to just play with all the elements, I got my sapphire shield here. I got my electric in the combo. So yeah, you just freeze enemies. You could use your fire wands in combination with them. And yeah, these are the electric ones. And you can spin around too, and all the balls will fly everywhere. Same thing with fire. Look at that, fireballs. Now, something cool that I like to do is I like putting very hard materials onto some of my boomerangs, because the armored enemies are really annoying, and I just like a separate weapon to be able to break them. So in this case, I'm using my silver Orblin horn on the fusion here with a basic boomerang. And what I do is when I initiate a fight with a group of enemies, I am going right for the armored enemy to break them because they are so annoying. So just like that, boom, silver bokoblin armor is now done. And then we can just initiate the fight, and things can just go in chaos. While we're on the boomerang subject, if you put something towards a boomerang and fuse it, here's all you have to do. You just have to throw this up all the way in the air. So face up to the sky, just like this. Look up, throw it, and just move a little straight and to the left. That's it. Just run straight to the left, and your boomerang's gonna be dancing around like this. But you have to move pretty quick in order to pull that off. Now, I just wanted to show you some cool attachments on the boomerang with some Gliok weapons. So here is the Thunder Gliok horn. So that's going to go through and do a lot of damage because it is raining. So the enemies are going to get wrecked with that one. And while the enemies are chasing me over here, I go ahead and try to attempt the same thing where I throw it up in the sky, just like that. And I kind of run straight into the left, and it looks like it triggered and hit me too. But you know what? It got the enemies, so that's pretty cool. Here's an example with the ice one. So it'll just freeze a bunch of enemies. The red bokoblins easily just go down right away. And it's just a great way to completely just nonstop freeze enemies so they don't bother you. Here is an attempt with the ice boomerang in the sky. And then I run straight and a little to the left. And then the boomerang should rotate. Now, this one is my favorite one by far. And it's going to be summoning a death battle robot. This thing is going to destroy any enemy in your pathway. Oh, these are just amazing. Look at this. This thing is ready to go. It's got arms. It's got everything you need to power it up, and it's going to just go ahead and destroy the enemies. It's got electric weapon. So if an enemy comes up to it, it's going to get shocked. Yep, that enemy's getting hit right now. Oh man, it's beaming down everything. There's a silver bulk goblin. The red ones are just getting nuked. The blue one's hiding over there. And that silver one's done for. That silver one is going to be stuck in a shock loop until its death. Horrible way to go down, silver bulk goblin. I feel bad for you. Oh man. And the cool thing is, if you want to know how to build a bunch of death robots like this, you can actually check out this video right over here. Seriously, go ahead and click this right now. You'll be able to build so many cool robots.